so many of you here today to celebrate Mum and Dad's fabulous 50. So to start the proceedings, we're going to hand over to Chris, who's got a little something to tell you about.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
This is a bit unusual for me because obviously Sarah and Vicky aren't here, and Kate usually does all the speeches. It's certainly the first time I've ever been asked to do a speech. So, this is my time. So, I couldn't really think what to say. I didn't really want to think too hard about writing, so I thought, how can I possibly tell you about the period before Mum and Dad were married? Because obviously their love has lasted longer than 50 years. It's how many years in all? 56? 55?
55.
Okay, so 10 years ago, we found, come on Jack, come on. We found a lovely chest of all their love letters. Obviously a man who hasn't got married yet, so I need to work out what kind of a love creates such a union to last 50 years. Jazz, don't shake your head so much. So, their biggest challenge was when Mum went off to Margate.
Yeah, that was it.
You went off to Margate to perform in a show.
Yeah.
And it was only in 1963, 2 years into your relationship, Dad was crestfallen, as we'll discover. This is it, 1963, September 1963. My darling, darling Angela. I cannot possibly begin to tell you how much I love you. I love you with all my heart and everything else. I know, Jack. I don't. No, okay, you're okay. Oh, darling, I do so love you. I have never loved you so much. In fact, I almost want to cry into my pillow. As I sit here all alone looking at your heavenly photograph. I'm so sad because I'm not with you. I'm sad because you're going away from me. But I'm sure we'll be sensible about it and pull through this period, and I'm sure our love will be even stronger at the end than it is now. If that's possible. It is often said that boarding school is good for one because one values home so much more, having been away from home. Well, darling, for me, you are my homing target. You are home to me, darling. I have to apologize. There are funny parts, but it is ultimately quite sickly. I want to be with you forever and a day. Oh, darling, you left your white cardigan in Telstar. So it would seem a good idea, no, I mean excuse, for me to come over and drop in to see you. I will try to drop in either early afternoon or after 6 p.m. But honestly, darling, why oh why did you take off your cardigan on such a cold and rotten rainy day? But my darling, I am so in love with you. I want to be so close to you and to talk with you, but I'm afraid I have to tell you something pretty black.
I don't remember.
I've got to break my date with you because, unknown to me, all the children have been invited to dinner with my aunt, Susan, and Jim. God, did I make a fuss. I asked my dad what right he had to make my dates. And heaven knows what else. But it still remains. I will ring you before you get this letter to make other arrangements.
Where's she?
My darling, I just had to come up here to talk to you. I suddenly got the urge. I think it was the sight of the sun or something. Oh, I do love you so much. I feel it all over my body, shivers all over. I would just love to be lying in a field, hugging you. I must not let my imagination run away with me, or else the frustration will be unbearable. Well, soon we'll be back together. And I wonder how Charlie's back room is. Soft and dark? Oh, I love you, darling. Right. Well, darling, I must go to bed. I got quite a lot of work done this evening, and Jazz Club is now on the wireless. And their subject tonight is jazz partnerships. But to quote Steve Race, the greatest thing about jazz partnerships is the same as in all partnerships, i.e. great mutual trust. And that is us, darling. I'm writing to the beat of this fabulous jazz. It's so happy, and so am I. I really cannot stop thinking about you, and I like it. I love you so much, my darling. I will follow you for always, my darling. Wherever you go, whatever you do, I want you to be happy in our love. So please, darling, be happy in your work. I firmly believe that whatever will be, will be. But I do hope so much that all will go well with us. So that when we can love, love, love all our lives. Just wait until I have passed my exams and qualified. Then bingo, we will get married. Just imagine, my darling, us being together every day. It's so beautiful that it seems to me to be almost a dream beyond my reach. But darling, please let us encourage, caress, and generally manage the movement so that our love increases and makes our dream a reality. Darling, I love you. I love you and I'm so proud of you. You are so gorgeous, so beautiful. I really am so very proud to know that you love me. I feel very meek. Many, many boys must find you extremely attractive. And yet you chose me to love. And darling, you accept my love. It is all so wonderful. I long to see you as soon as possible. So adios, mon amigo. Ciao, Amy. Very romantic, very romantic. So what was the reply from Mum to Dad? What was it?
It'll be about food.
It will. At the time she was in Margate, living in Diggs, going to the theatre. So this was written between performances, coming in on and off stage. She scrawled away in the makeup room. My very own darling Adie. Love you heaps and masses, and will never stop telling you that. You are mine, all mine, completely mine. And I am yours. We love each other so much. So how could anything break or finish a relationship so totally marvellous as ours? I've made my little speech. Terribly sorry you've caught a cold, darling. We certainly do share everything. But a cold isn't the most gorgeous of things to share, is it? I remember when you had a cold when we first met, and it went on for ages, and I never caught it. Of course, though, we didn't know each other so well then.
Oh my God!
Must now dash. I've got to go to the theatre to perform. We'll continue talking to you later, my darling. I love you heaps and think of you the whole time. Down at the theatre now for the next show of the evening, and I'll be writing this whenever I have spare minutes during the show. Suddenly felt a great rush of love for you. It goes soaring from my feet to my head, and it's ever so heavenly.
Oh my God.
Miss you, masses, darling. Really do. I do want to live with you, bracket, not in sin. Generations that Zoe has no idea what that meant. Marriage and all that jazz. I think of life with you would be paradise, our own little world of love. Every day we would wake up, see each other, say good morning, darling, have a burnt breakfast, which would improve as the years go on a few more. 35, probably. I gaze at my gorgeous ring and think very hard of my darling Adie, who gave me the beautiful ring to bind us together. Tighter than we ever were, I'm going to have to leave you again to get ready for the finale. All love until I'm in bed. In bed now, safely tucked up after a steaming hot bath, with a cup of tea brewing beside me. Gorgeous smooching music on the radio. Rosemary Clooney is now singing You'll Never Know How Much I Miss You. Oh, darling, bracket, deep sighs. Anna Lou and Maria, the illusionists, have arrived home, and we have doves rizzing around everywhere. At the end of her act, she has three come flying over the audience and land on her head. Well, the first night, they weren't at all cooperative, just didn't like the theatre, and when Anna Lou whistled, they just didn't come. So for the rest of the show, there were doves flying all around the audience. And the audience were really very good, didn't seem to mind at all. But the sketch I'm in follows immediately after, and we all had great fun doing little skips and hops to avoid the doves' droppings. And the stage was covered in feathers. Oh, my darling, how I long for your next letter. I really love them, and keep them in my bag until the next one comes. Then I put the last one into a big cellophane bag with the rest. I wish you were here, darling. I so love to talk to you in person. I love our conversations. I feel we really gain something from them. In fact, I feel we gain something from every little thing we do. Love you so much. That's the bestest thing about the whole relationship. Masses of love is flowing through this pen to you now. All my fondest love to you, my marvellous AD, from your adoring Angela. So, happy anniversary. That's the love it takes for 50 years. I pass you on for the married years, to Kate.
Oh, I'm not quite sure how to follow that. That's scary. So, as you know, they got married at the tender age of 21 and 23. Ooh. It's an amazing fact that these days, one in five of people that age meet online. So, and 64% of those say that shared interests are the most important factor in a marriage. So I just thought I'd run a compatibility test on young Angela Partridge and Adrian Watney. Well, I'm quite sure at 19, Adrian would have firmly listed his interests and loves in this order: Sherborne, cricket, rugger, golf, and sports cars. More recently, he loves nothing more than the high life in London, the Mercers, attending dinners, giving speeches, and much to Mum's horror, shooting. Yeah. Angela, on the other hand, was the all-singing, all-dancing ballerina who had posters of food on her wall, was appearing on the stage in Margate, and likes nothing more now than a game of tennis, coffee with friends, visiting the ballet or theatre, her garden, life in Horsley, and of course the grandchildren.
Yes!
I'm sorry to say, I'm not sure they would have made it through the first stage of online dating. Dad, of course, is an eternal optimist and is ever hopeful that he will convert Mum to his ways. Every Christmas and birthday, the moment would come for Dad to present Mum with her presents from him. There would be a lot of rustling, and then he'd appear armed with carrier bags from Harrods, Selfridges, Harvey Nicks, and a card that he'd never quite written on or put in the envelope. There was always a palpable sense of tension amongst us children as Mum opened the glamorous contents of the bag, gamely tried them on. Some would look fabulous, but she would always give a big sigh and say, "Oh, Aid, I wish you'd gone to M&S." Of the Mont Blanc pen or the laptop computer. She certainly keeps him grounded. So I'm going to ditch the importance of shared interests and say there are two words that have made that are the key reason for a successful marriage: optimism from Dad and tolerance from Mum. Of course, there's tons of things they both love, but some stand out as being solid staples of this marriage. The tea's made.
Yes.
It's perhaps unique to my parents as one of the most important things to have on your wedding list and then bedside table. And no morning in the last 50 years has been without a very, very weak cup of Earl Grey tea and some slightly off milk that's sitting there all night. Mum won't get up without that. The shared love of their vegetable garden and the curious annual stress about being on holiday when all their hard work comes to fruition. Dad has been known to fly home from Port Gramont mid-holiday and return with a carrier bag of runner beans. And of course their love of dancing and a good party. And for the last 30 years, Port Gramont has been their place to stop and relax. Their inability to say no to anything makes for an unbelievably busy life at home. So in PG, the pace slows down, the rosé is on tap, and it's been a wonderful place for us all to get together and enjoy each other's company. The grandchildren love it. The only downside is the lack of clothing worn by their grandparents. Above all, Anne and Aid are a great team with a great friendship. They're totally united, as we've heard, in their love for each other and their family and, of course, their friends. They've created this wonderful home, Mansard Cottage, and they gave Sarah, Vicky, Chris and I the most fantastic childhood, encouraging us in everything from sport, drama, dance and music. And they welcomed our friends for countless meals, parties and holidays. In fact, their hospitality has been legendary amongst our friends. Now that Moll and I have reached the age of teenage parties, I look back in wonder at how tolerant and welcoming they were. Mum always seemed to manage to churn out enough food for unexpected dinner guests, and even in Port Gramont, the house was constantly overflowing with extra bodies. But they never complained, and they always made it great fun, which is why no one ever wanted to leave. We're enormously proud of them both. They've achieved so much with successful careers, an abundance of charity work, and an enthusiasm and zest for life that is often hard to keep up with. So congratulations, Mum and Dad, for a wonderful, busy, loving, fun 50 years. Yeah. Four children and seven grandchildren later, they've been the most brilliant grandparents and parents, which is why I'm now going to hand over to Zoe.
Everyone. Granny asked me to say a few words on behalf of all the seven grandchildren, as I'm the oldest. It's quite hard to know where to start because there's a lot of things that Granny and Grandpa cover in our lives. But they truly mean so much to us all, and it's such a big part of our lives in so many ways. Even though four of your grandchildren live so far away, you still manage to be in their lives despite that. So I have countless cherished memories of Granny and Grandpa. Some of them include fairy stories. They were a big highlight for me, and Granny would always come up with the most amazing stories and take me off to this magical land. And it was one of the best things about coming to stay and seeing Granny.
Thanks, so.
And Grandpa's words of wisdom. And of course, the same jokes that he tells every single day. We attempt to laugh now, as we've had them so many times. And of course, his brilliant one-liners, such as, I get so many cards on Valentine's Day, people think it's my birthday. That comes out every year as well. And also our lovely week in Cornwall we had this summer, where it's so nice to have, we actually had the whole family in one country, in one place, all at the same time, believe it or not. And that was lovely, and I think that will be something that we always remember. And so, can everyone please be standing to do a toast for Granny and Grandpa?
Well done, Granny.
And now we've got a little video that Chris has put together. It's a mixture. I don't know if some of you may have seen the Cornwall video that Chris made, but it's a little tidbits from the grandchildren in this video. We've got a makeshift. We've got a projector. We've got a makeshift screen. We're hoping that it's going to work. I hope you enjoy it.
Happy anniversary, Granny and Grandpa. We wish we were there. We miss you and we love you.
From
Vancouver, Canada.
Happy anniversary!
We hope you're having a lovely time there today. We're thinking about you masses, and we wish we could be there, but we did have a fantastic week with you all in Cornwall, memories which we will never forget.
Yeah. We love you and we miss you so much. We wish you have a really good wedding anniversary. Bye.
I love you, Granny and Grandpa. Happy golden anniversary. Bye.
Bye bye from Brazil. Ooh. Let's give him a big kiss. Ready?
Bye bye.
Cheese.
Down in my mind where you
there's nothing that I wouldn't do to make you feel my love. To make you feel my love.